Right guys, hey, how's doing? Coming back for another episode of Fallout. This is our third week actually.
Fallout 4?
Fallout 4, well, I think they know, Ken, come on. It's Fallout, you're playing the new one.
Maybe they've been in a bunker for 200 years.
Now we're frozen. we'll continue on with this, we'll see where we go.
Say something.
That Piper lass has been a bit of a slut. Keeps asking me to do an interview or something. So. Minge bag, that's her character name, in case Nanny's getting that. It's along the lines of
just really to, oh, 1 second, just to let people know as well that the winner of the competition, we've now
got because we've got 100 followers, that's awesome guys.
I hope that's scrolling across there. It's Irek Scrubs. That's
yes, I won!
Yeah. Yeah, she got what I was like,
I just got a great 100 feet forward just so. I get it.
Irek Scrubs won the competition, so we'll be sending you an email. We'll get your probably send you a private message in Twitch, and we'll send you what the potential prize is, and you can choose between the two. We're just going straight in the game, then, yeah.
I'm just one of the. Nate is really interesting in dialogue. It's all about the killing, really.
Right. Okay,
so what did they win?
Well, the choice of prizes is you can either win. It was like the Mario stuff I had. So it was the Mario hat, the Splatoon amiibo, and a badge thing. Or if they're a developer or they do any stuff like that, if they've got artwork or anything, as long as it's not offensive, they can put it up on the Small Fry Unify like streams, the bit that's got an advert.
Oh,
so they have that for a weekly advertising or whatever. So us, like, if the person wants that, they can send us their stuff. And then when we come back after the new year, that'll be up for the first week in the new year's streams, so we'll have that.
Oh,
so
that's pretty awesome.
So if they've got a game they want to promote, it's like, essentially I'm going to be charging any developers or like game developers money for that, so that'll be like £100 or whatever worth of free marketing stuff, so you get to promote your game for a week. You can put up a video, an image, whatever you want, or I said if you've got a message you want to send someone for a message to say I love you or something, you know, people doing it, they propose to their partners and everything, you could have it up there. It really depends.
Stop talking about proposals, so it's, I can't really the water that.
I am immortal. You know, I guess you kind of are, aren't you?
Oh, make sure the Sims comes in this.
I'm a woman at a time. So, you've seen the Commonwealth, Diamond City. How does it compare to...
I think the Sims coming through. Is it coming through? Is the Sims coming through? I think so.
Hey, Sean, she just asked, Ken. What's different between now and when you were, well, before the war?
I've been having too much fun blowing things up to
think. Sound is working. Hey, everyone's joining us, by the way, on Twitch and YouTube. Anyone that's on YouTube, what I'll do is I'll keep an eye on that. I'll try and keep an eye on both, obviously. I'll keep an eye on both, but it's difficult when I've only got one set of hands here. If Phil joins later on, maybe on the chat, because I know he's not coming to the studio tonight. If he joins in the chat, maybe see if he can cover the YouTube stuff and pass over the messages, but if not, I'll try and go back and forward. So,
handiwork is all over. Since synthetic people sent from their hidden labs to do the Institute's dirty work, sometimes they even replace a person with a synth double.
With a synth double,
on whatever suspect. Now, not everything that goes wrong has the Institute behind it, but there's always
try to work out what way the fuck she's even talking. I'm really interested.
Aye, so did you remind people what happened last time? What we got up to last time?
We didn't do nothing last time, we just blew shit up. That was me, I explained it. All that's happened so far is we went to Diamond City. We've already talked about how we were in Sanctuary. I started building that up, but who cares about that? Sanctuary, just leave it. I'll focus on the story this time round. We'll just go through... Oh, shut up, Piper. We'll just go through the story in this episode, I think. So.
There's a lot of
confusing things about it for me.
I was watching a video on IGN and the guys showed you a video of how to get it's called a fat boy, a mini fat boy. You can get one straight at the start. Did you see it?
No, I've not seen it, but I came here talking to the fat boy with the mini.
There's a bit you have to run to, it takes like about take a minute or 2 minutes to run there. You run there and it's got a nuke and you get the fusion reactor and stuff like that, the fusion cores or whatever.
Alright, well, looking that up, tell me where it is and I'm going to wash it up.
A bit of spill, can you hear? Because I probably can't hear that.
Sounds like they might be.
There's nobody can hear that, but ethical.
People, let me know if you can hear this.
For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want you to make a statement to Diamond City directly. The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. Everyone wants to pretend it just doesn't happen. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one?
America?
Too scared or too numb?
Sweep everyone under the rug?
This is stuff made for filling corners. You have a wee look at that. It's just like you can do notes on them, you can add things if you want, just until you get into the swingings, like for each episode. One of the commenters made a point that when we're doing the shows, it's different with certain games. Like obviously, Shenmue, like I was explaining, Shenmue and Super Mario, you can't really narrate those games because they're just kind of like the Shenmue one. I'm just playing through an old game, and anyone that's watching has probably seen the game already, so there's no point in telling them the story. But what I'm saying is, like, it might be quite good if we narrate a little bit more, or comment a little bit more on what we're actually doing as we're doing it, sort of kind of thing.
Alright.
So.
Well, I'm just seeing a bit of banter with this.
He's just drinking some Iron Brew right now. That's a sippy Iron Brew there, putting the can down. We can narrate the whole thing like that.
People just ignore kidnappings out here? Yeah, Blue, you haven't noticed?
They give us shit to call me Blue. I think it's because we've got, like, black and blue eyes because it...
I thought you called you blue because your outfit, you made up the blue one because you come in the vault.
Aye, but I've not got the outfit on and she's never seen me with the outfit, so that's bad coding right there.
Aye, but she knows you're from there. She can tell that you've been in there.
But I've never wore that vault. How does she know, like, what...
Oh, you would have been in first grade, didn't you?
No. I went straight into her like, she doesn't know, so I've just met her. Mm. She's a bit slutty, actually. I think it's a hat.
Maybe she knows that anyone that came in the vault got Chelsea's smell.
I know,
it's
quite stupid,
it's like a joke. I'll take anger over apathy any day. Good quote.
Oh, will you now?
Stop calling me Blue. It's
insulting.
Blue
Hida. I'll blue your Hida.
Actually, it'd be so easy to...
I didn't know if you were on the up and up before. Didn't want to waste my friend's time, but I think he can help you. His name's Nick Valentine, detective extraordinaire. At an office here in Diamond City. Just look for the neon sign with the heart in it.
Neon sign with a heart? You sure he's not running a brothel?
No!
That would be hilarious, but no. No.
Who's this?
Anyway.
What's she doing?
I'm with you, right? Watch your back. Just say the word when you're ready.
Well, she's going to be my companion now, but I've got a dog meat. I didn't need her, she's useless.
I didn't need two dogs.
I know, fuck off, bitch. No, I know you, dog.
Does it?
How you doing, buddy?
How you doing, buddy?
What I need is to train some stuff.
Hey.
What stuff have I got again? How much is shit in here? Oh, power, I forgot about power armor in there. That is awesome in here. What is stuff? Anyway, should be fine.
Anything I can do?
You
just say hello.
Ah, so Piper's wanting to come with me.
Not by myself.
I think the dog's made useful purely because...
Can you send both of them off at the same time? Or you can only take one?
No, you can only take one.
Really? You can only take one?
But see, in Fallout 3, this was what was brilliant about it. Fallout 3, you got the dog and the dog would come with you whenever, that's it. And you could also get a companion. Can we leave the dog and a companion?
She's instantly put them off or she smokes, so they like smokers.
You just blow that right out of her mouth.
I don't like smoking! I managed to catch her head there as well.
Kablamo.
Kablam! Kablam, motherfuckers!
Yeah, I can take this, some steel or this. I'll take that as well. No, I don't need that. Hot plate, no.
Is that person in the background?
I don't know. Who is that actually?
No.
Hi there.
Paper to newcomers. Institute grabs you in the night. At least we
won't. You're a cheaty bastard.
Sarcasm.
Sounds like quality.
I'm serious. You should read up if you're sticking around.
I'll be fine.
I'll stick you in the nude!
There are only people criticising the dialogue options in this game, Sean, and I totally agree. Like, the options there, I had one of them was sarcastic.
Mm-hmm.
It's a sarcastic response. But in any other Fallout game, that is exactly what you see, that would come up exactly what you were going to say.
Mm.
But now I'll say, oh, you guys be sarcastic, and it says something totally different. It says, oh, I didn't know why to say that, it's rude. I mean, I get it's sarcastic, but still.
Yeah,
you
know, I think
Fallout
is definitely
going to
be a big thing.
Mm-mm. I've got too much stuff going on here. Can I kill super mutants? I'll get annihilated. However, you can romance companions in this.
You can romance it.
You could, but it's too much effort. Plus, you didn't really get in and you just got a perk.
Aye, perky tits.
Aye.
Nice!
It's just the well rested perk you get. It's like bonus XP earned for a certain amount of time. Which a character would get laid.
Everyone is one of those things.
Let's die through here. Weaponry. So I'm talking about this guy.
Get out! Somebody said that there. Get out!
That should be like the main villain in this game. Just
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Aye, just
hey there. You should stop by myself.
You didn't expect me! Get out! Now!
It's like, I'm playing the game.
Got all this ammo I could just take, but I'm not allowed.
Arturo.
I've been dealing guns all my life. So did my dad. One day my
daughter. You just need to lose dodgy.
You have kids? My daughter's shy.
Uh-huh.
Oh lord, she goes through books like mad.
Oh my god, there it is there. There's a mini nuke.
So if you steal it, do you go crazy?
Aye, the wolf or not. However, that is a mini nuke that I need to hate.
Yeah, if you had the mini launcher, you could have been blowing his face off right now.
Why does he keep following me?
Hey Arturo.
You take care.
What do you mean you take care? Why the bike?
Take care, eh? You take care of me.
For sake. Gotta buy shit. Alright, so where was the fat man now?
It's like when you come into the vault, you've got to go to your left and it's like you just run along there for about 2 minutes. And there's about there.
Right, I'm going to look that up during the break and then we'll go and get that so we can both shut up.
Institute has to have energy, right?
What? You mean the railroad? That's a fairy tale, man. It don't
exist. Okay, we'll go right here. Nice. I heard from my
cousin. He knows a guy that works for him.
Mm-hmm. He told you that wouldn't last forever.
We said what now?
His ties. Oh, Nick.
Oh, no.
Oh, man, you go and rescue him or something.
Sorry, coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
Office is closed.
I know you must be busy, but I won't.
Fucking office closed, you know.
It's important. You don't get it. The detective, he's gone. Missing. Don't worry, I can help. Tell me what happened.
Maybe I'll help.
Nick was working the case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he trapped them down to their hideout in Kirk Street Station. There's an old vault down there that they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out.
I don't know if Nick Valentine's a synth. He's a robot.
Mm-hmm.
I'd love to help, but there's the small matter of expenses.
So who was it was saying? The whole story behind this? Was it? It's all about you're like against the Siths or something, the Siths.
Aye, they're like the bad guys, the Institute, they make robots and stuff.
Why is that a bad thing?
This is your point.
Didn't we discuss this?
Because they kidnap people.
Okay. Why? Why did they kidnap people?
Last
do what?
Put some real money on the table.
Why did they kidnap people? To do what?
They're assholes.
I'll pay you if you find Nick, but it's going to be 100 caps. That's the reward.
See, I hate this. This is a dialogue at work again. I could ask for money, and it was in Yale. Yale means that it's likely going to work. You're likely going to be able to persuade them to give. So I got 125 caps instead of 100. So I done it again, and I got 150, but then it went red to say that it's unlikely it's going to work. But I thought, oh, can I press it anyway and see what happens?
I gotta pack up.
And now she's saying, ah, no, you're only getting 100 caps now. But it used to work on a percentage base in Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas, where, well, it was a 40% chance that was going to work, mm-hmm. an 80% chance it was going to work. See, oh, okay,
hey, okay. I'd love to help, but there's the small matter of expenses. Don't play games with me. I'll pay you if you find.
So I just lost 50 caps.
Only 100 caps.
Should I actually go 200 or whatever?
It's not up for negotiation.
I suppose so.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing.
Ah, he is. I'm pretty sure he is. I'm sure I've seen a video there. He's got these bright yellow eyes. Mm. He's a robot.
Ah, people gonna have yellow eyes.
No, it's glowing.
So yellow jaundice. We've got jaundice now, so yellow skin and yellow eyes. I don't have yellow eyes, I'm picking up.
Good old yellow eyes. What are you staring at the guy's eyes for?
Good news for people that's joining us. It's quite quiet instead, but anyone that does join us, if you're watching back in this, good news is we will have hopefully better quality stream sim going forward. I've ordered the thing for the studio.
Okay.
It's a little simmed, simmed receiver.
Microphone?
No.
What the hell was that?
It's a thing for processing sim anyway. But you can basically plug wireless mics into the lapel mics. You can plug like. It's like an adapter thing that you can use in your camera. So basically that will allow us to plug multiple lapel mics into it as long as I get the extension cables for them. So we can sit here with lapel mics on, extend the cable over to the box, and it can take in the actual channels. And once I get wireless ones, we can go wireless as well. But it means you can have both of the sound from the room much clearer, because it'll be just from the lapel mic. So that'll be clear. You didn't have to have the TV up as loud, you can turn that down, because we'll get the sound coming directly from the game. So you just have to take it to the camera, and it'll all be going through this box instead. What the hell? Who just blew his head off there?
Show's over. There are no synths in Diamond City. Hear me? Just you folks and your damn paranoia.
What went on?
The fuck happened there?
But what happened is, him, Kyle, pointed a gun at Riley.
Yeah, called
and,
him
said, and called him a robot, essentially. Where's the real Riley? Riley says, no, I'm human. And the suit guys went, fuck it, he's dying. And just blew his head off.
Maybe he is a sim thing. Now he's a sin, definitely.
Your brother's dead. He would have killed you.
I'm not a sin. I told him. I kept telling him. Why didn't he listen to me? I need a minute. What's everyone still standing around for?
He's a bit calm, but his brother was getting his hand blown off. In front of him.
In front of everybody.
I understand, officer. I just want to know what happened.
What, you didn't hear the shouting? Guy pulls a gun on his own brother, thinking he's a sin. It's that newspaper's fault. Got people all riled up, thinking their own family might be replaced by machines. Look, I'm sorry you got caught up in all this, but it's over, okay? Just go about your business like
that. Well, if I didn't want to go about my business, I'll just blow your heat up. It's going to be easy.
Officer.
Move along!
You're telling me to move along, getting sick of that, you're annoying me. But that's what I mean, it should be like, see if I'm pointing a gun at his head, everybody should turn and go, oh, what's happening here, a wee bit of action. Because like...
No, there's a guy who's lying there with his head missing.
Aye, and chunks of meat. Look, folks just walk away.
Where's the dog not eating them as well? That's a couple of bits of free meat. That's free meat.
Hey.
That's a meal.
See if he had anything worth taking.
Like his head.
Inspect.
Grab anything useful.
Excellent. See, Doug meets. Hold on. Doug, here. Inspect.
Go check that out.
Inspect. Smell.
Sniff his arms.
Check it out.
Oh, you're fucking useless, Doug. As per.
Yeah, maybe it's telling you you've got to take the women. Maybe that's why. Maybe she goes up and chats him up. There's a guy.
I hear a bit of fun on that.
Pickpockets him and stuff.
Well, you didn't know this. See, we've got a frag grenade. You can walk. You can walk.
You peel one off in someone.
Huh?
You peel it off.
Hold on. I'll see if I can do it. I'll save it now because obviously we know how to screw our sleeves up. Save it now. But I'm better pretty sure I've opened the knees first, but might hit. Shoot it. No, there's a security.
Radioactive as a TV star.
Right, frag grenade. Watch us.
So is this your frag grenade?
Aye, what happens is you just pull the pin, stick it in their pants.
Did you put on them? Didn't you do
anything? I did.
Does that mean you've not got any?
No, I have got them. They should be dead. They should be in a million bits.
Didn't you do anything though? I've never seen you do anything. Does anyone show you?
You should be dead.
Try again. Does he not blow up as well at the same time?
No, he shouldn't have. When I placed that on him, he should have got wasted there. He should have got absolutely annihilated. Well, because that's what happens. In the old Fallout games, you go up to somebody, put a grenade in their pocket and run away, and you just blow into a million bits.
No, as soon as you did it, he instantly knew you'd done it.
The second time, I didn't know the first time, though.
The first time it worked though.
There was a grenade in there, that's what he was. Try with him.
He's not done it again. He's not done it again.
Where is he indeed?
He should definitely put it on them.
Aye, it should.
He just shakes it off.
He can't shake that off.
You shook it off too much.
But anyway, we'll go back to the same and just be normal about it. But God's sake, what's that all about? I'm going to look that up, by the way, because I'm sure that when, if you put a grenade in somebody, it would pull the pin, chuck it in, and then it just explode. There was nothing you could do about it.
The thing is, it should be showing you going like that.
Pulling open his stretchy trousers and just drop it in. And then pissing off.
See what the hell did you drop that? Dead.
Well, see, like, when you're pickpocketing people in Assassin's Creed, you would brush into them. When you've done it and you see his hand go into his pocket and swipe. Obviously, any time he got caught, he wasn't bothered because nobody's got to stand up to an assassin. But, you know. So that was pretty cool. Right, let's go in here and see what we can do. Anything exciting happened this week then?
The working stuff.
Aye.
Or gaming or.
Not
really, I was off for a couple of days while I knackered back. Still came down here to do the streams though. But yeah, Wednesday was just. Tuesday, almost got through a shame too when you joined. Messed up that hour. I've now got the emulator working online on the PC, so I can now play it and finish off that last hour. So depending on the time you finish tonight, I might do that.
I was going to say, yeah.
My Dreamcast is goose now, so.
Is it gone?
Well, it's not gone. I need to fix it, but the little card reader thing's knackered in it. So I need to get that fixed, but I was trying to fix it and screw it up more. So I've got the emulator working and I can finish it off in it. I can actually run it in two times the resolution anyway. So it's actually, I can run it in 720p, which is what we're streaming anyway. I was streaming before that, but it was a bit blurry and stuff. But I can now run it in 720p with double the resolution of what I had before. So it's a lot cleaner and a lot sharper than what it was. It looks pretty good, it runs pretty well, and I checked it with the Xbox controller. You're on the wired one, I got that working. With the Xbox One one, you're right, I need to get the bloody adapter thing. You get the wireless adapter thing.
Aye.
Fucking pain in the arse, but £20 for a wireless adapter. So if you buy the controller for £40 or £50 or whatever it is, it should come with the fucking adapter. In fact, you shouldn't even need the adapter. a modern day computer, I don't understand why they can't just connect it up wirelessly. What's the fucking, what's the hassle with that? Anyway, so I'm quite excited because I've got that working. So I'm going to finish off that stream. And then Wednesday, yeah, we hit the 100 followers, which was awesome. It's like Super Mario Maker, man, it was jam packed. Levels were flying over the place and everyone was coming.
How many people was watching?
13, 14 and stuff like that. And,
that's pretty good.
Yeah, on Twitch. It was good for us, but it's like the comments are just flying over the place. Kind of just like, oh, and people were joking about the levels and stuff, and you couldn't actually keep up with the comments. Or something to go back and get the levels and try and copy them over and stuff. So I was like, holy shit! It was really, really good. That was good fun. Some really cracking levels people sent us. So I enjoyed playing them. I think that's definitely a game we'll just carry on each week, going into 2016. We'll just play that as a permanent fixture until another type of game comes out. So yes, yeah, so that was cool. But, and then, what was I doing yesterday? Day off yesterday, just getting some stream stuff tidied up, like. And then, yeah, I've slept in today till 4 o'clock.
Till 4 o'clock?
Aye. It's been knackered the last week, though.
Oh, shit.
Hello, dog. Have a bullet to the face. And another.
Can't take any, man. Look at that, we've got machine gun turrets and everything, but he's just sitting in the bed. Oh, look here. Oh.
A bit.
Oh, military. Hey, talk to you, is that what you said? They're nice. Salute.
What did they say, military?
Military grade duct tape. Because apparently regular duct tape isn't military grade.
Let's see. Yeah, but apart from that, I was looking forward to kind of getting the streams finished up this week. Finished Pokemon, in fact, on yesterday, Friday, sorry, yeah, Friday was something else. Finished off Pokemon Colosseum, so that was good, cool, finishing that up. So we're going to move on with maybe a more mainstream Pokemon game, because Colosseum is a bit of a obscure one. Just doing butcher sort of things, I guess.
I ate them all. Dragged them all. It's because I was looking at mongrel dog meat there. Oh, frazzled.
Frazzled.
No, I didn't fall.
Do you drag any stuff like? Rag bag.
Just pull it up all their defences. I'll need playing that game, man. I'm out of here. There's too many of them. I'll run out of. Oh, shit! Oh my god, oh my god! So good. Safe and sound.
Inject yourself. Get some, motherfucker!
For sake. Oh! Oh, he's gone. He is gone. Oh, where the hell did he come from? Oh my god. Shit. Oh shit, I'm out of here.
This is episode three of this, yeah.
This is episode three,
aye. But I've put it on YouTube for some reason, episode five. When did I put that? That was weird. That was weird.
I'm killing boys. Because he's being really, really cheeky. I wonder what dubs.
This is better. Episode three.
Oh, shit. Too distracted with stuff. He'll shoot me. Seriously, what the hell shoot me? Excellent. Oh, dog. You're homeless. Metal. Check that real quick. Take all of that as well. This is me just trying to get to a place to...
It seems like YouTube gaming. It seems like the channel's dead, by the way. See, when you go into it, you look at how many people are watching certain games. Like, I'm checking there how many live certain games there is of Fallout 4. And the highest one is someone with 10 people watching. That's the highest.
For Fallout 4?
For Fallout 4.
Seriously?
Yeah, that's crazy, isn't
it? This game's died quick.
Yeah, it seems to have just went... But I think, you know what's happening? I think it's happening quite a lot nowadays, is you're getting games like the... people are getting the games early.
And that's where all the hype is.
Aye. So it's like two weeks or a month before the game even comes out. It's just all over the place and all the sites are covering it, and it's like you're getting thousands and millions of people watching it, and then as soon as the game comes out, that's it. It's just, the hype's died off.
Right, where did I go with this? Where did I go with this? I don't know what the level for that. Nah, that's a wee good one here. Yeah. Stuff. Oh, what vicious snarl have you got, like?
You see what vicious snarl is?
The dog's got a vicious, she's just at it. He's just at it. I don't care if it's a guy or a lassie dog, by the way. Oh, what a clue.
It's probably based on what you are as a character.
It's probably just something to annoy me.
So what's been happening with yourself? Like, did you play, like you said you played some of this stuff, what did you find out about the game and who?
Not that I just went and slaughtered everybody that I could. I've never done anything really apart from that. Just diving about, getting some supplies and shit, but I never actually done, I never went into any buildings or that, just because I didn't want to waste any.
You still enjoying it, or?
I do actually really like it. It's just, it's sometimes hard to, because I like talking, I think we've been talking about the game and that, so you're not really that bothered about how it's gone. So that's play it myself and drop that. It's all about the damage resistance. We've got all the damage resistance now, so it's all good. We'll drop that. A shit ton of weapons, I'll tell you that much. Sucks. I've got an ammo shop. I'm really interested in that. This will be good to use it, I think. damage and that's pretty decent. Favourite that. Drop that in there. There we go, good to go. Right, so.
Come up. No, I was thinking, see, watching like games like this, because all of these are like obviously based in America and stuff. I was thinking, imagine if something did go tits up here, like a zombie apocalypse. Obviously, it's not real, but let's say something like that was real, like you got in a zombie apocalypse. It's like, how hard would it be to find a gun here?
It depends who you know.
No, but I'm just saying, like, in general, like, you look at America, you find a gun like that, probably. But here, you'd be like, right, I need to get some guns. Where the hell do you find guns? You go to a shop and you get a toy one with a fucking red cap in the end there or something. Look, I'm fucked! There's no weapons.
But in the UK we'd focus a bit more on bladed weapons.
Yeah, probably.
I think that's more our style.
Right, there's a flaw. Someone's hanging for the rope. Like they've been hanged, but the head's missing. To your right. There. So you want to look at it? So their head, like, they've got their head on. Their head's missing, I mean. Oh, they're chained up. I thought they were hanging. Maybe they're chained up for their clothes there.
Super mutant, where? Oh, shit. Oh, there's more than one. I'm in the wrong place. I'm trying to get there, to the left, but it's just been one bit of chaos after another here.
That's see. What it's designed for, though.
Quick save this.
There.
So now we need to go here. Try to keep walking. Maybe they'll look normal.
Automatons. Sounds like some cool weapons in it.
Oh!
Right in his head. He's going to have a headache.
They didn't like that one at all. I've
got this way.
Oh, let's sprint away from here. Right, we should be nearly there. What's this? Oh, nice.
Squirrel bits.
Believe it or not, I love it when I find these bodies. Sounds sick, but what a good gear. Being vicious. Snarling viciously. Supposed to be friendly dog meat. Discover none of these places and there's really no point to them at all. Oh, what's the idea? What can we find? Anything more than this Saturday, Sean?
I don't know, to be honest.
Maybe something wrong is causing it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's some good stuff right there. What's this? I've got to go in here, haven't I? Right, let's go in. I feel like I'm getting led into a trap here, but I'll activate it anyway.
I'm giving you a psychedelic look there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there was some this weekend.
Possibly something. Can't believe I actually says that. Poisoned wine. Well, I better drink it.
No!
Can't waste wine. Oh, that's really what happened in here. I've now got a core out of these.
I rock the tempo all the way.
Problem is, oh Jesus, gosh, why I'm saving.
That's good. It's quiet the night. Oh, it's always quiet the first hour anyway, so. Some more.
Ah, oh, shit. I disengage the lock, so I'm out into that safe.
See the new trailer for Star Wars?
I've seen most of the trailers for Star Wars.
Sounds so good then.
You know where to go and see it?
Yeah. I'm organising a something for work. You want to come to that as well?
May as well still work there.
You know, you sure? 19 grand you'd be on right now, plus your backdated pay. You know how much money Graham got?
I don't know if we should be saying it on camera. suddenly he's going to be feeling a bit sexy and that is. He's going to be like, oh, guys, I just put my number down there and also put a wee bit of cash there.
$4,000.
It's not bad, like.
Like you're charming bastard.
I bet he bought a new PC.
He's buying one for a server, he said. He's going to set up a server in his house so he can run it all from his server. It's like, cool. I've been royally screwed over, obviously, as well. I'm losing money and I didn't get backdated money either because I was with an agency at the time. Like, if I hadn't been with him, I would have got it. If I hadn't got the full-time contract when I was meant to get one, I would have got it. Because I never, because of the screw ups, I went nicked. In fact, I'm getting less money.
So where the cookie crumbles?
It is, it's fucking bullshit though. You're sitting there and everyone's like, ah, it's a $2,000 for my Christmas. You're like, you bastards. They're sitting there me fucking partying in that. Fuckers. What can you do though, eh?
Going up? No, we're going down.
Stop being shit.
An idiot. I was alright, got a wee bit of money with that, that day. What were we talking about there?
Money.
Money. Money's no the be all and end all. It is. I mean, you've got a wee bit of cash and that, obviously that's good, but it's no like, that's it. Money's kind of irrelevant. If you can make it so that money's irrelevant, you're jamming.
If you can make it so money's irrelevant, it's because you've got money.
No. Well, I tell you what, you wouldn't mind getting $100 million in the bank, but apparently your happiness won't get any higher.
Aye.
It's supposed to be one.
Rich people always say that though.
It's like, oh, I'm so sad. Get the jet ski out.
I think it's like this, right? It's like there's a lot of people, they've got money before they've got anything else because they've been born into it and stuff. So what happens is, they've got money already and then they're trying to get happiness and they use the money to try and get happiness and they never get happy, so they're miserable. So then they say, money doesn't buy you happiness. It doesn't it? It can buy you a lot of things that should make you happy. However, if you're skint in the first place and you get happiness and you get this kind of stuff you want, but then you get money on top of that, it just makes these things a little bit easier and less stressful. Then you're like, right.
Money can help people that haven't got it. Like, if you've not got money and you come into money, you will tend to spend that money a bit better on stuff you need, rather than somebody that's got money and then they, like, if you give us $5,000 and you get a billionaire $5,000, the billionaire doesn't really get shit, but that's fine. But to us $5,000, you're like, oh, nice, $5,000.
Like, imagine you had money, right? Let's say you had money to set, like, chuck $50,000 into the studio. Let's say you're a millionaire. And a lot of people do this that have got money, they're like, got loads of money, they'll just chuck. They'll say, right, I'm going to chuck $200,000 into this business, and if it fails, it doesn't matter.
So if it becomes successful, I'll make a fortune.
Ah, exactly. So they'll chuck $200,000 into it. So you'd sit there, you'd say, right, I've got all this stuff, blah, blah, blah. And you'd come in, you'd be like, I've got nothing to fight for, I've got nothing to work for. So you're just like, all right, okay, whatever, cool. It's not going that well. It's been quiet this week, I'm just going to shut up shop. I'm going to call it right off. They move on to the next one. And they just go through loads of businesses like that until they hit a jammer. That's what Dragon's Den is like. They just sit and go through loads of businesses until they get one that makes some fortunes. Whereas, like right now, it's like, right, we need money to do certain things. We need money to buy more cameras, more lights, PC equipment, computers, games. And so it's like, if I had some money right now, I'd be like, right, I've got this stuff set up. We're ready, we're in place to do it, but we're getting held back now because we need the money to do it. If we've got the money, you'd be like, boom! Hey Donovan, how you doing, dude?
Hey.
Hey, hey! And the head just floats down. You're getting wasted here.
Hey, but. Sorry, I've got a dog that's...
He was shooting at the guy there. Thought he was on your side.
Need to do my side, I'm doing it by myself. Maybe if the dog would get involved a wee bit, eh?
They'll just walk around, they're calm and peaceful. Wolves are spraying over the place. Oh, maybe that's what, yeah, that's what they're shooting at the dog, right? See, that to me, they shot him three times in the back there.
Aye, should be done.
The first shot, it should be on the, like, on the ground. In agony.
Right, that's it. I'm going to deal with him first one.
In agony! I would rather die 1,000 times in agony than have a dog.
Eh? What's wrong with a dog, like?
I'm trying to think of something silly. That's from Star Trek, the one with... I forgot what his name is now. Look at that, look! You see the box, look. Look at this. That's obviously clear where the design comes from. Look at that.
Pretty cool, actually. I need to drop some stuff.
What's been happening with yourself, Donovan? You had a good week?
Drop knuckles, don't need that. Where else do I drop? No, I want to keep that, obviously. Don't need two of them.
Mm-hmm.
Screw it, didn't need that, yeah. That should be alright.
Was that a battered fedora? Sweet.
Cigarettes, Subway coping, got to take them for some reason.
I'll get my fake fedora on. Sweet. How much it costs for a fedora? It's like 300 quid for like one of these hats. No, this one is a fake one.
Ah,
you get a proper one, like it's like 300 quid in that, 400 quid.
No, I'm paying that. 300 quid for a hat!
It's because they make them, the material's made out of it, it's obviously a fancy material. But it's also shaped, like they're measuring your head properly and stuff, so it's designed specifically for you, like a lot of them.
Aye, but what if you put on weight?
Well, your head's not going to put on weight that much.
Well,
might not, you, like, if you're spending 300 quid on a hat, chances are you've got another 300 quid to buy another one when your head gets fat. It's not you go, ah, one day, ah, fits, next day you go, oh my god, my head's fat, it's not fitting. It'll probably stretch. It'll probably stretch with your head.
Yes. Bottle caps, bourbon, right, take that. Five fatigues, take that. Duct tape, take that. Wonder glue, take that.
Wonder glue!
Cap stash, pork and beans, ah, I'm loving the dream here.
Pork and beans. Next, you stop that.
What are you whimpering at? Dog!
Dog's wanting something.
What happened to you? Oh, freak, man.
Did he get injured during the fight? You sure?
No, he's an idiot. What? Right, still got it. I just like this because it does the most damage per hit. I mean, now you need to run in it, technically, and just scalp him right in the face with it, but...
The thing is, Dax looks like something, like, obviously it's meant to just be a pipe that's been bent over. It's, in fact, it's a crowbar!
It is. It's a pipe, but it's bladed.
It's a crowbar. Look at the end of it.
It's a tyre iron.
Aye. And it's
a bit... It's a bladed tyre iron, that's actually cool.
But that reminds me of Half-Life. That's why, though, because it's a fucking crowbar.
We're going about it, just smashing into it, hoping we can break stuff and we really can't. Because it followed.
Who's there?
It's me.
It's me, motherfuckers. Have an axe to the face.
Steal
some ammo real quick. Right. Oh shit. I think the game loses some of its drama a little bit of its, like obviously this is just another shooter. But the music's so peaceful and calm.
It's like
no. That's
just the radio
that we're playing. It feels like this game clearly obviously just meant to be a long it's designed as a but it's like a long play game, but you just play this for like 100 hours, 150 hours, whatever. It's not like one of these ones where it's got a story like that builds up and forces you through the story where you get a really climactic bit, you know? It's not like the story's building. It's just quite, like, you know what I mean?
Aye, you're just you're there to get a laugh, really. It's not about the story itself. See, look at that. Just double jumped right here, that. Get in there and attack. Distract them.
See, this is where these games need to change up. This is what I think. I think what they should do is, see you as a character, you should be able to take multi hits because you're the character. You don't want to be dying as soon as you get cut by a bullet.
Well, so you want to go full on Star Wars where this thing, where the bullets are just flying everywhere but the target.
No, I'm missing. Like, right now, you're shooting guys, you're shooting them several times. But I pretty much guarantee the developer would say, oh, but if it's one bullet kills, then you'd be dead instantly, you'd be dying all the time. But why not have you take them loads of hits, but they only take one bullet? If you shoot them in the right place, they'll die with one shot. I'm not talking about taking their heads off, but they'll die with one shot. If you shoot them in, like, the face or in the heart or something. But anyway, you shoot them, you'll get the physical reaction, you'll knock them flying. But you, on the other hand, you can take loads of bullets because you're the hero. You're like the player, so it shouldn't be like that with you. But then instead, you see like these guys here, they're running, they're taking loads of hits. You then have it, you can put the programmer more into the AI and say, right, let's have better AI then. They're not going to just jump out in front of you and get shot 20 times.
Well, that's the problem, is they can't do it anyway, they don't know what they're talking about.
What do you mean?
Well, with their AI, they don't know how to make good AI. Nobody knows how to make good AI these days.
Yeah.
They just don't know how to do it. The pathfinding is terrible. Look, this dog will stand in front of the only door into a building, and you've got to move away and then come back to it just to get into a building. Yeah. You should be able to do it. You should just be able to do what you want.
That's the thing. These games companies need to start developing better AI. Get really good, intelligent AI. And really good, I mean, way
it's,
better than
it's possible. I have seen it happen. You can actually. Well, you're kidding. I didn't just find that right there.
In a bin.
A fusion core.
Just chuck them away.
Where is it? Where is it? I can't believe I just found a fully charged fusion core, which are like hen's teeth, and I just found one in the trash.
As I was saying, someone just binned it.
You
do realise though, that's exactly where someone would pick, but like, Leeds is going to check in a trash can for a fusion core.
There's no mate me.
Exactly. Welcome to my game, motherfuckers! Straight in the bin.
I think Fallout rewards players for being thorough with stuff.
For being scavengers in bins.
Aye.
Try to teach you, so if there's an apocalypse, go into the bins. Go in bins and stuff.
I went anyway. Well, you go to search it.
Is that a shotgun?
Nah, it's a short hunting rifle, but it's rubbish. There's something better already. Nothing here.
Nothing in the safe.
I can't get in the safe.
How come?
Expert. Well, it's too difficult.
What the fuck?
I know. In the old Fallout game, could you? I think you could.
I don't know, like, what happens, like, I think you can build up your level and you'd be able to go and go back and look
at it. You level up and then you basically select it as a pair. Get it, but
you're going to come back all the days, but here, or does this mean that you come back to anyway?
No, but I'll never come back to that purely because.
So, I've got a bit in the game, unless you go away, level up, which is probably hours and hours and hours away.
Ah, this is part of the story. Kevin, I mean, that's just bullshit about it. And who do we know that's going to go through the story and mind who we notes down to say, right, I better come back and unlock the safe? Nobody cares. Because they're right by it, and it's like, oh, I can't get it.
Yeah.
So,
it's probably something amazing in it, though.
Aye, probably. I bet there's a... Oh, what's this? Look at Coca-Cola Quantum. Dibs.
Was it the Nuka Cola Quantum they were selling, the one I was telling you about, they were selling at the stores for loads? So that there, what's that about? It's like, you're about 50 metres away from them, and they all suddenly all snapped around and started shooting. They might be even fucking you here.
Or, what you should be able to do in a game like this, is just come in and absolutely annihilate.
Sneak up on them, yeah.
Or you can sneak up on them, but I choose not to.
You're saying you can stick up on them, but they just instantly snap in there. How was that?
Because they've got that detection crap, you know, which they shouldn't have, but they have.
So here, maybe go back. Did he have suspenders? Did I just say?
Suspenders and slacks.
You're wearing his wife's clothes again. He deserves to be dead. And.
Oh, here we go, in the vault.
What's it saying?
There's that hand coming out again. See, they should have made that a USB stick. They really should have. And then in that, once you got the pit boy, that should come out USB stick. That should be artwork, man.
Yeah.
See what I mean? How simple would that be, Dave? But you'd be like, nah, that's nice.
Well, what's a USB stick cost nowadays? A couple of quid for a 16 gig or something?
Aye.
Chuck it on 16 gig, you could put a movie on there.
Oh my god!
What the fuck?
Oh god damn it, dog meat.
That stirs their combat. What the fuck is that pose he's doing as well? What's that?
That's him hiding.
It's fucking atrocious. There's some bits in the game that are quite bad, like stuff like that. But the game itself, I still think it looks pretty good. I think that, see, like, the in-room sections, the indoor sections, I think it's quite generic. There's loads of stuff, but it's quite generic. It's not that impressive graphically or anything. But see, when you're outside, it looks really cool.
Aye, the outdoor environment.
Yeah. This could just be any game, you know, it's got a little bit more detail, but this could just be any. Could be Soma, Bioshock.
Doesn't it look like it's anything different? We've got in here, scavenge some stuff. Oh, always got in some stuff, thanks. Jumpsuit, dibs. Radaway, excellent. Medex, need all that. We need oil it.
Easy. Got your camera in my hand.
Oh, my new favourite song is Wanderer, by the way.
Hello, Wanderer.
Oh. Aye, the one for the Fallout trailer. The actual live action trailer.
That got copyrighted, by the way, on one of the videos. They picked it up.
Oh my god, man. Bastards. Damn. They were nothing, by the way.
Yeah.
So like you're not
even. That's us, by the way, an hour into the game.
No.
A wee break or?
I'll take a wee break now. I'm about to dive into another wee bit, so.
Just see.
I'll see.
50 minutes, 59 minutes we're in there. So, I'm chucking a wee break.
That's good. Back in 5, guys.